I want somebody that plays by the rules, and that's not Jeffrey Bravo.
Oh, big super kick.
Goes for the cover. One, two, three. We got a new champion. Look at that. There's your champion. There's the new face of the UWC. That's Silly Billy.
Boys and girls, it's another fun-filled night here in the UWC arena, and there's a new sheriff in town. Check out my sweet badge, new UWC Heavyweight Champion, Silly Billy. It's unreal. It's been the greatest month of my life. I mean, when I first came here a couple years ago, I didn't expect to be the World Heavyweight Champion. I just wanted to be friends with everybody. I wanted to make the kids laugh. I wanted to make the people go home just saying that they had a good time. But then Jeff Bravo, the new kid on the block that wants to make a name for himself, he comes in here, he starts sending all these people after me to take me out. So one by one, I have to beat all these people down, and then I learned a sweet new word called irony. And that's for you, Jeff Bravo. How ironic is it that you send all these people after me to take me down, and now who's the one laying in the hospital bed with their foot up in the air, out of action, for good? For good. So I get rid of Jeff Bravo, and I got your belt. But I get here tonight, and I find out the bounty's still on. Jeff Bravo's not here. Shut up! Jeff Bravo's not here, and I still got people coming after me trying to collect this bounty. But you know what, Jeff Bravo? You go ahead and watch what I do to Big Rig tonight from your little hotel room, or your little hospital room, and you get well real soon, and you come back and you try to take this from me. I kind of felt bad for a little bit that you hurt yourself, but you know what? I would have beat you anyway. New UWC champion.
UWC, as always, keeping the United down. Always trying to keep us down. First, the UWC, what do? They fire Mike Grimaldi as commissioner. Then, they expel Joe Rules from the UWC. Now, they expel Jeffrey Bravo after he lost the title to Silly Billy. It's just an injustice, and it just can't happen. So what we're going to do, I've been in close contact with Jeffrey Bravo. And Jeffrey Bravo has said that the bounty that got him suspended from the UWC is back on. And that me and the Big Rig are going to collect it tonight. Actually, the Big Rig's going to do all the work, and I'm going to make sure I'm going to pull all the strings and make sure he's doing the right thing. And then when we take the title, we're going to collect it. Was it $10,000?
Yes, 10 G's.
$10,000 bounty from Jeffrey Bravo. That's pretty much all we need to do.
Fans, and welcome to another exciting edition of UWC Championship Wrestling. I'm Chris Wilcox, and right now we're here in the UWC control room. Right now our UWC studios are under construction, a little bit of construction going on right there, so we don't have access to those at the present time, but you can see right here our state-of-the-art control room. This is where we edit each and every one of our UWC videos for UWC Championship Wrestling each and every week. Just a little glimpse of some of the behind-the-scenes action that goes on here in the UWC. We had a great show for you this week, another action-packed episode. We only have one match for you, but it's a big one. UWC Heavyweight Championship is on the line. Silly Billy makes his first defense, and he's going to go one-on-one with the Big Rig. And you just heard comments from both men. Both men are really amped up and excited for this big action-packed match. Silly Billy just won the UWC Heavyweight Championship right here last week on UWC Championship Wrestling, defeated Jeffrey Bravo. And Scott Volk, the UWC commissioner, had said a couple months ago that if Jeffrey Bravo loses the UWC Heavyweight Championship, the very next day, he's going to be indefinitely suspended, much like Joe Rules when he put the bounty on the head of Silly Billy. So Jeffrey Bravo, he's out of here for the foreseeable future until somebody takes pity on him and decides to reinstate him. And look at Joe Rules. Joe Rules hasn't been reinstated, so it could be a very long time before we see Jeffrey Bravo in a UWC ring. Obviously, he's not happy about that. The United not happy about that. They've amped that bounty all the way up to $10,000. The Big Rig looking to collect the UWC Heavyweight Championship, $10,000 bounty. A lot on the line. Enough of the talking. Let's go to the ring right now.
Yeah.
always seems like we have an argument there in the middle of the ring about whether or not Billy should take up the title belt.
So you're telling me, Chris Wilcox, that our UWC Heavyweight Champion doesn't even know that he's not allowed to compete with that championship?
Aye, but he may be trying to get himself a good advantage against the big rig. You know about getting unfair advantages, wouldn't you now?
Now, I'm joining your own commentary by Mr. Black and Captain Justice Garrison, and we have an agreement at commentation table where there is no fighting, so Justice, don't attack him. As much as I might like to see it, we can't have that here.
Well, Wilcox, why don't you pay attention? We got Silly Billy's first ever defense of the UWC Championship here against the Big Rig.
Member of the United, Big Rig, coming after here for his fallen leader, Jeffrey Bravo, suspended indefinitely by the UWC Board of Directors for that bounty that he had on the head of Silly Billy.
Didn't Big Rig also win the Bronze Royal Rumble, giving him their shots?
I remember,
because he threw me out.
He did win that Rumble, and that's why he has the title match. If you had won that match, you would be in the ring right now with Silly Billy.
Aye.
Oh, God. I can't imagine what that would be like.
The crowd chanting for wrestling. I think Big Rig's about to give it to him. Seems like Big Rig brought a lot of fans of his own in that big truck of his when he pulled into the parking lot. I saw a lot of people coming out of that big trailer. I think he's trying to stack the fan. That's Silly Billy's biggest advantage, is the fan crowd favorite, and he's trying to stack the crowd against it.
Silly Billy's biggest advantage is that he's an idiot.
How is that an advantage?
Because he's too dumb to know any better.
Aye, so that means he's evenly matched with Big Rig, because they're both big, dumb lummoxes.
Very hate to agree with Garrison.
And there's the power advantage of the Big Rig, the 303-pounder from Nashville, Tennessee, home of Nick Gulas.
Well, Silly Billy lost one of his trademark habits.
But he has it back on.
Aye, this is Silly Billy's first title defense on the champion. After chasing and going after bounty hunter after bounty hunter, he now finally has a championship, and he has to go against the Big Rig, Raven United.
He had faced a lot of bounty hunters. He faced Vinny DeMarco, he faced Warhead, he faced Jason Karloff, the Black Dragon, and then the Monster Atu. The bounty kept going up, but nobody ever took Silly Billy out.
Well, apparently the Big Race is going to try to make up for lost time here.
Well, the bounty's up to $10,000, which will buy a lot of new tires for that truck, because I saw it's in pretty bad shape.
What is he doing now? Now he's got another ridiculous hat.
This is a Viking hat. You're the one to talk about ridiculous facial wear.
I'll give you a ridiculous facial.
I don't know what that means. Big Rig and Billy squaring
up. I'm really about to lock up, but oh.
Go behind right there. Big Rig with the go behind of his own.
Big Rig's the master of the go behind.
Biceps.
Me and Big Rig are no strangers to each other. We battled many a time in the past, not to mention in the Rumble himself, where he threw me out after taking out my partner, who saved myself from the Rumble elimination.
That's very noble of him.
Aye, that's why he's my first mate.
Now, you guys wrestled Big Rig and his old partner Bubba for the tag team titles. You won the tag team titles from him, actually.
Is he really going for a legend?
I believe he is.
Did he just pull his underwear off?
Oh my goodness.
My God, is he wearing underwear?
He's wearing
Iron Man.
Oh my God, Chris, another wrestler has raided your underwear drawer.
That's ridiculous. I do not wear Iron Man underwear.
Are you sure? I can check right now. Because it might be. I mean.
No, I know we like to steal things. Let's leave my pants alone, thank you. The crowd will thank you later. Big Rig drawing with some fans. Does not see Billy is right behind him.
He just tapped him on the shoulder.
Still doesn't see him. This is some
Big
Bugs Bunny stuff out here.
Big Billy thinks it's Billy Madison.
He said some offensive things. The crowd did not appreciate it.
Oh.
And another one. And one for Philly Madison. For a man that wears glasses, Philly Madison gets punched a lot.
He just has a very punchable face.
I agree. So does Mr. Black underneath that mask.
Absolutely.
What? You agree with that?
No. I'm disagreeing with you, and hopefully you'll go away.
And now you just threw Billy into the ring apron. Better be careful. Both men might get counted out here.
He just clubbered away on Silly Billy. Silly Billy trying to take a breather. Off the ropes.
Big forearm.
Billy showing some actual wrestling acumen right now.
Yeah, I know. That was very clever to bounce off the ropes from the floor. I think Billy's a lot more clever than people give him credit for. He's silly, but he's not dumb.
He's not?
No.
Then why did he just walk into that?
Low bridge.
Now he's... They hurt his knee on that. Now Big Rig going to town.
Oh, he's got a count of five to break that. He's got a genius at ringside like Philly Madison to remind you.
And Philly Madison to help out.
I was actually Philly Madison. I can see you from here, Philly. I'm going to be telling, I'll be telling all the commissioners about it.
Commissioner Scott Volk not refereeing this one. He gave the assignment to George Naha, the senior official here.
At least it does a better job than what was his name?
Mike Grimaldi?
Yes, that man was awful.
He was a very bad referee and a very bad commissioner and an extremely bad man.
Listen, I don't know why you're obsessed with this guy. I think you better pay attention to this match. Silly Billy's about to be taken out permanently.
What'd you say again, Grimaldi?
I don't know. Who is this Grimaldi guy you're talking to?
Going to town on that knee.
He's wrenching away.
You know, Justice Garrison owes you a thing or two for costing him the tag team titles.
Look, Billy Madison's showing him the diagram of how to apply the pressure.
Now he's taunting referee with the book.
Oh, he's probably got the reversal in there, but I don't think Billy can read it anyway.
The fans trying to get behind Billy. You hear them chanting, Billy, Billy, Billy.
Billy, Billy.
What are you chanting, Wilcox?
It's catchy.
So is Hercules. I don't expect you to start chanting it.
It's a good point. You will never hear me chanting that. Big Rig, this evil man, trying to take out Silly Billy, take out the D, and get that $10,000 bounty in the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Big one hand there by Billy.
And another one, right to the midsection. Kicks him right in the knee, sweeps the leg. And now he's got him in that spinning toe hold, applying pressure, more pressure to the knee.
You know, we're seeing a lot more serious side here in the Big Rig. I think that 10 grand means a whole lot to him.
And the UWC Heavyweight Championship. Sorry.
Right, he's definitely applying some very tactical holds. He's trying to wear his legs out, which is an impressive thing to do to stop him from using that super kick.
Now, last year, when Bubba challenged Biggie Biggs for the UWC Heavyweight Championship, I know that Joe Rules put both Big Rig and Bubba through submission training. I think we're finally starting to see that pay off with the Big Rig in the middle of the ring. Big Rig pointing like he's figured this all out. There's the charge, big clothesline in the corner.
Billy looks like he has no clue where he is. And again, that's not new.
You know what they say, you really can't pedal upstream with a bad oar. And Big Rig's making sure to break that oar of Silly Billy.
Oh, he wraps the knee across the ring turnbuckle.
That's actually a ring post. But...
Ring post. That'll cripple a man. That can't be condoned here in UWC.
Well, he's going for it again. It's Billy Madison against George Naha. Completely distracted.
It might only be a matter of time. You know, Silly Billy went through a big mental toll when he was going through the bounty hunters before. And I don't know, it might be too much for him to expect him to come back from this.
You know, it's very possible he put so much into winning that heavyweight championship that after he won it, you know, it's a whole other deal once everybody else here in the UWC is coming for you. Silly Billy's got a giant target on his stupid head.
And Big Rig trying to get a bullseye on that target. Choking him in the ropes right there. And there's textbook Billy Madison, the leader of the United.
Wilcox, I can hear from here. Silly Billy just said some very very disparaging comments about Philly Madison's mustache.
He should have.
It's a very, very disturbing looking mustache.
I think, I had a theory. We're doing balloting here for the UWC year-end awards. I think he grew that mustache so he can win most hated. Knife edge chops and right hands. Can't run off the ropes, though.
Having a little bit of trouble running the ropes.
Not a lot of momentum behind that. And Big Rig, a big man on him anyway. It's neat in the midsection.
And there it is, Wilcox, what I told you. He's just not that bright.
He's fighting against all odds here. He's got more guts than brains, perhaps.
Man, that'll tear your leg right out of the socket. They're going to need to give him a peg.
That's a good point. Do you have a spare one in your trunk?
Aye, you just need to cut the other one off.
Okay. I know someone who might need that peg, by the way. Talk to me after the show.
Billy now, trying to fire off. Silly Billy could pass out from the pain here.
Only gets a count of two.
And he's just barely hanging on. I can see Silly Billy, you can see the pain on his face. He's getting worn down.
Nope.
Big man assault.
Nobody in this crowd would blame Billy if he gave up, lost the UWC Heavyweight Championship, but was able to walk tomorrow. That's for sure. Big right hands. Gonna whip him into the other turnbuckle.
Here comes the big man.
He misses the charge.
Here is face first.
Billy's just giving it everything. Everything he can have, and he can give it to him.
Uh-oh, under loose in the head.
Oh, that could be it right there. It could be done. It could be all over and done with.
Billy Madison in the ring and out. One,
two, three. Silly Billy retains the title.
That is pure will and intention. There is no reason that man should be standing after the assault on his knee. And that just tells you how much a fighter Billy is. And I respect that man very much. But what's happening here?
Wait a second. Billy Madison just took out Silly
Billy.
Again,
here's a numbers game.
Here comes Warhead.
Here's a numbers game. It's coming out here. And I'm going to take off my stash and put myself down. And I'm going to go in there right now.
You got to stay here.
This is a numbers game. This is the kind of stuff that the Secret Society is known for and United is trying to do. You can't take a man out one-on-one. You try to take him when he's down. And it's pathetic. Pathetic like you are, Mr. Black.
Oh, the United.
Oh! Splashes that knee. Much like he did to Biggie Biggie's arm.
I'm going in there.
All right. Justice Garrison making the save. I don't know. Oh, man. I think they just took Silly Billy out. I don't know if he's going to be able to walk after that. Wait a second. He just stole the belt. Big Rig just stole the belt. He's not the winner. He lost. He lost in that super kick.
Hey, Chris. Who's got the belt in his hands right now?
It was a gang assault on Silly Billy. They just took out his knee.
That was the best thing that ever happened to the UWC.
That's terrible. Big Rig walking out with the UWC Heavyweight Championship.
Look at Silly Billy. He can't even get to his feet.
Silly Billy, oh my. Oh my goodness.
Billy Billy gonna try to get back to his feet here.
Oh, he can't. He can't walk.
He might have broke his leg.
He may have broken his leg right there. Oh, you hate to see that sort of thing here. Wait a second, Biggie Biggs wants the microphone. What does he have to say?
Oh, God.
Hey, I know you guys are sick and tired of this United and Big Rig taking out the stars of the UWC. I'm sick
Graves punk card.
Sure did.
You want to be a shot caller? You want to make this like a prison yard? Stick your head out and look at me like a man.
What you said, man? What you just said to me?
You are playing this game. Let's take it to us. You think you're the champ? You think you're the president of the UWC? Huh? You think you're the people's champion?
You pop up whenever something's going right for me. It's time for you to shut your mouth.